Okay, hello everybody, and welcome back to Dragon Age Inquisition, where I'm going to open this door, even though I probably don't need to. Father's guidance. Stupid dad leaves his kid. And now I have to inform somebody about it. Okay, so I guess technically this place isn't really super green. But it's nice and open. It's greener over where the Dalish elves are. Memorials of the Second March. I mean, the Exalted Plains, I think, is one of the biggest areas, really. It's huge. Oh, I think there's another marker up there. Oh! This is... I just gotta, like, burn that right... Oh, hey, there's an arcane guy. Ooh, don't follow me. I didn't realize I could just sneak up on the backside. That's nice. With Linderane fell the Dales. That was one of my favorite little short stories that you find. The wildest and murderous of them all was the she-elf Linderane. With Linderane fell the Dales. What's this? Oh, rash vine nettle. Okay, sorry about that. The video was doing weird things. I noticed in the corner of my eye. And I'm kind of testing it out now. But I went back up to 60 frames a second. Well, so that'll be interesting to see how the video does. Ooh, look at him! He looks so freaking rad. It's unbelievable. Dorian, you're a lucky guy. I just tell you that. But I'm gonna kind of be keeping an eye on it over there.
Solus, I take it you study spirits.
You.
Back in my home, we keep spirits as servants.
So I have been told.
The things they can be made to do are quite marvelous. You should see them.
Imperium is not the safest place.
Ah.
Dorian tries so hard to make friends. Solus is just not having any of it, though. One of the recruits from Valroy said they saw the famous Tom Rainier drinking at the Halberd east of Valroy. I thought you'd be interested given your history, although the lad's probably only seen him in sketches. Somehow I doubt the old captain's foolish enough to come within 100 miles of the capital. I'll let you decide whether you believe it. Anyway, I heard you might be relieved in a week or two. You could talk to Prulix, see if he'll... He did allow you to enlist for our side even after what happened with Calliere. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, I remember reading this before and, like, not knowing what Tom Rainier was, but oh my gosh. Wow. Wow. That's intense. My gosh, that's intense. What do you think, Black Wall? I almost called him Blackbeard. It's the poop that has the sad weapon schematic in it. Nice. I'm on a mission to succeed. Well, actually, I'm on a mission to, you know, get with Dorian. But whatever. It's all good. It's close. Save the world. Get with Dorian. It's all good. I'm really hoping the recording's doing what it's supposed to. Freaking funeral. Do you see this, Solus? Do you see this right here? Explain this to me. Lots was explained at the end of Trespasser. I know a lot of people weren't really happy with it, but it is what it is at this point. These aren't the Venatori. They are the Venatori. Hey, look at that. Let's get the mage guy. Hiya! You cannot see me, and I'm going to do this one. Oh, wait. Nope, that one. That was not what I wanted to do, but here we go. Dorian greatly approves. I am glad that you greatly approve, Dorian. If only we could. If only we could. Alright, I want to go talk to Dorian now that we have... Now that we've completed his little personal side quest, which I don't remember last time if I had to... You know what I did? I actually do remember fighting the Venatori. We came around that corner and I was like, oh yeah, this is where we get to Venatori. Huh, alright then. Okay, once again, I had to stop recording and change it back to 30 frames a second because 60 was just doing weird things. So, we'll see, guys. It was updated today, and I have been playing all day, so...
Stefan finally
died. Oh, there we go.
It was a blessing, really. He's been in so much pain since Haven. He was out of his mind at the end. He smiled. Said he smelled his mother's turnip stew. It slipped away.
There we go. Now we've got the... We've got all the coal incidences, I think. I was noticing a lot more shiny armor around. I think it's because we companioned up with the Templars. So not as many mage robes running around. We've got more Templars running around. But a little bit of both. Oh, hey, wait, let's see how many... Three, okay. Oh, four. One, two, three, four. That, like, didn't render for a second. That was weird. Right, this is the Templars, and this is us. This is Haven burning. That's the breach opening, and that's... me... It's before we sealed the breach, actually. Dorian, I did your quest. Yes!
Anything interesting? A letter regarding a friend. I mentioned Alexis to you, didn't I? His son. I was trying to discover what became of him. Where he ended up.
And?
Nothing. Redcliffe is abandoned.
What?
And there's no trace of him. It's as if he never existed. I think the Venatori found out he was helping me. I think they killed him.
Are you all right?
He was ill, and thus on borrowed time anyhow.
That doesn't mean you can't regret his death.
I know. Felix used to sneak me treats from the kitchens when I was working late
in his
father's study.
No, I like Felix.
Don't get into trouble on my behalf, I tell him. I like trouble, he'd say. Tevinter could use more mages like him. Those who put the good of others above themselves.
What was he doing in Redcliffe if he wasn't part of the Venatori?
He was there with his father. In fact, Felix was the reason I knew where the Venatori were. He planned to help if you came to Redcliffe, I understand. He had so much more than I to lose by helping. He should be alive, not I.
I'm not going to ask that question, because I know the answer. We'll try this. I'm not trying to suck up, I'm just trying to think of the nicest thing to say. That's not very nice, and that's not very nice either, so... Blah.
You make it sound like he was a better person than you.
What a mad thing to say. Few people are better than I. Very well, a better person, clearly, not nearly as handsome.
I am sorry.
Thankfully, Felix wasn't the only decent sort kicking around Thedas.
No, thank you!
I could watch you roam Skyhold.
What?
Here and there you run checking what? In on your followers. Why don't they come to you, feed you grapes, rub your shoulders? I suppose it's more fun this way. For me, I mean. You're rather strapping.
What was that? He just booped, too. Did you see that? It is late here. Okay. That just sounds so cheesy, you know? Like, that would be more, I think, along the lines of what I want to say, but I think you have to do these romance options to make things happen, you know? Okay, let's give it a go!
I've noticed you're rather strapping.
I'm not strapping, I'm scrawny.
That only takes eyes.
Luckily, I...
You do. A rather fine pair. At any rate, you didn't pass by...
Yes, I did!
Something on your mind?
Oh, no! That was so cute! And it doesn't sound too cheeseball-y coming from Talon, so that's good.
You said Alexius was a mentor of yours.
He was my patron, sponsoring me to the higher levels of the Circle of Magi.
You're in the dark.
In return, my successes were his. I had a lot of successes, naturally. Alexius was most pleased. He and I used to talk over brandy about the corruption, how we could one day make real change in the Imperium. And then he gave up. He stopped trying.
Why did he give up?
On a journey to Hossburg, a darkspawn raid killed his wife and sickened his son. I remember hearing the news. He hadn't been there, you see. Alexius was convinced he could have protected them. The guilt tore him up. I helped him with his research for a while, and then we drifted apart.
That must have been difficult.
Back then, I was furious. I told him to snap out of it, move on. I thought I had all the answers. Later, I regretted my hasty words. But we didn't speak again until he approached me for the Venatori. Too much pride, I suppose. Plus, I was busy drinking. One must have priorities.
Was it hard being away from him?
It was hard not having a patron, yes. I'm not exactly built to fit in. At any rate, he's dead now. More's the pity.
I should go.
Try not to kill anyone without me.
I'm sorry.
The Inquisitor's work is never done, I see.
I should go.
Here I thought we were just getting to the good.
I wish, Dorian. Although we did make some good progress, I will admit that. Hopefully the recording's working or I will just bust a cap. What's the exclamation point here? Oh! Hello?
My Lord Inquisitor, okay. It's good of you to speak with me. I have news
for no!
Companions.
Oh!
Is that a note of distaste I detect, Mother Giselle?
I admit his presence here makes me uncomfortable, Inquisitor. But my feelings
I thought, okay, here's it coming.
I have been in contact with his family. House Pavas, out of Carinas. Are you familiar with them?
Why exactly would you be contacting Dorian's family?
I didn't contact them, Inquisitor. They contacted me. The family sent a letter
describing they know that you were with us?
From their son and pleading for my aid. They've asked to arrange a meeting quietly without telling him. They fear it's the only way.
I ain't lying to him.
Since you seem to be on good terms with the young man, I'd hoped.
Are you sure this isn't some kind of trap? I mean, the secrecy.
That did occur to me. What if it is a plot of those mages, the Venatori? Another reason to put this in your hands.
Yeah, so you don't have to deal with it.
I pray that isn't the case. But if it is, you are far better equipped than I to respond to such treachery.
Such treachery.
Why would his family contact you?
Because they don't know you, Inquisitor. I am not of the Imperial Chantry, but they know what I represent. These are parents concerned about the welfare of their son. How could I not do whatever possible? I would speak to the young man myself, but he does not care for me. Thus I come to you. If any good can come of this, we must try.
They don't want Dorian to know. That seems odd.
They believe the young man would refuse, and the letter implies he'd have cause. Yet, they are remorseful for whatever came before. This is a chance for dialogue. There is deceit in bringing the young man to this meeting without his foreknowledge, I know. But does it not lead to a greater kindness if there is potential for reconciliation?
Just what kind of meeting do you have in mind?
I believe they just want to talk, to understand why Dorian felt
Dorian, I like
somewhere
that.
Private, away from Skyhold, but not in Tevinter. You make them nervous. They don't understand why he's here with the Inquisition. They want him to come home.
What happens if Dorian doesn't agree?
Hopefully that will be the end of it. If not, well,
I think Mother Giselle means the best.
That's why you should be there.
If you think I'm going to trick Dorian into meeting his family...
Oh, I feared you might say that. The family will send a retainer to meet the young man at the Red Cliff Tavern, to take him onward. If he truly does not wish this reunion, he can always end the matter there. I pray you change your mind, Inquisitor. Perhaps their letter will persuade you. If there is any chance of success in this, it behooves us to act.
Even in the asking, I find it difficult to believe myself. Considering my son is the only way. I know him. He'd be too proud. Family retainer, he'll bring the boy. He's not a boy, he's a man. He's a man. I'm not just gonna sneak that up on him. No way am I gonna sneak that up on him. This recording darn well better be working because we're doing Dorian's quest and I'll be so peeved if it's not working. And da-da-da, Dorian.
Something?
That was the game, that little glitchy sound. Tell your daddy called.
Dorian, there's a letter you need to see.
A letter? Is it a naughty letter? A humorous proposal from some Antivan dowager?
Not quite. It's...
Ogle!
From my father. I see. And what does Magister Hallward want, pray tell?
A meeting.
Show me this letter.
Of course.
I know my son. What my father knows of me would barely fill a thimble. This is so typical. I'm willing to bet this retainer is a henchman, hired to knock me on the head and drag me back to Tevinter.
I won't let him.
That would be hard to do while I stood there.
He expects me to travel with Mother Giselle, although Maker knows why he'd
think
I would.
That'd be an awkward journey.
Let's go. Let's meet this so-called family retainer. If it's a trap, we escape and kill everyone. You're good at that. If it's not, I send the man back to my father with a message that he can stick his alarm in his wit's end.
There seems to be bad blood between you and your family.
Interesting turn
of phrase. Yeah.
But you're correct. They don't care for my choices, nor I for theirs.
Because you wouldn't get married. Because you left.
That too.
You should talk to him.
I think you should meet with this retainer. Find out what your family wants.
I didn't ask what you thought, did I?
Don't be mean.
That was unworthy, I apologize.
Thank you.
There'd be no harm in hearing what this man of my father's has to say. If I don't like it, however, I want to leave.
Fair enough.
That works for me.
I wonder how much my father paid this man to wait around just in case I showed.
We'll find out soon enough.
All right, Dorian. Is that it?
I can't believe my father's goal. Of course, he couldn't come here to Skyhold. No, that would be too much. But contacting some southern cleric on the sly, much wiser.
this is some venatory connivance, I will be utterly disappointed.
Okay.
I should go.
I do rather like watching...
Okay! Well, alrighty then. Okie dokie. Smokey, let's go. I just don't know how long this is gonna be. Oh, shoot, we gotta go find Redcliffe now. Oh, no. We're so far away from Redcliffe. I think... Yes, we will go here. We're definitely bringing Dorian. And... Cole and... Iron Bull. Sure. Looks good to me. Looks good to me. Alright. I'm excited. This is gonna be fun. It's gonna be different playing as a man romancing Dorian in this part, because before as a female it was just like, oh yeah, okay. Now it's gonna be a little different. I should stop talking. Whoa. It was all of a sudden like, whoa. Come along, Dorian. We're gonna go talk to your daddy. Oh, I think I did turn up the sound on my end. Hang on, let me just break everything while I try to arrange my legs again. Okay, we will find Redcliffe much faster than we did last time. We totally will. It's not even gonna be, we're gonna find Redcliffe Road. It's gonna be really easy. It's gonna be great. It's not even gonna be a problem. We are totally gonna find it. Oh, I think that's that it. I think this is like the back road, right? I think it's just right up through there, though, so... this way? No, this way? Whoa, what? For real, Fox? For real? I wouldn't have even done anything, man, but you, like, aggroed. You're not even gonna give me anything. Cool. Oh, that's not bad. Not bad at all. Alright, then... Did we on Redcliffe Road? I wasn't paying attention. Did we find it? I think we did. Nope. Nope. Whoopsie. That's the one. That's the ticket there. Is it straight through here? Or... No. It's this way? We're supposed to just follow Redcliffe Road. It's not supposed to be a problem. I will admit, my bow and arrow looks kind of like somebody ripped somebody's organs out and made it in a sort of a bow shape. I think... Oh, here's the windmill. Sweet mama. I don't think we even touched Redcliffe at all. We might have fended off the, like, time warp, but I might have actually gone back in time to not even touch that, because I wasn't sure how it would be. I can't remember. Interesting that we can come here, though. I mean, I almost feel like Redcliffe would actually be in pieces, but I guess the only reason that Alexius did the whole, like, explode time with magic thing when I was there was because I aggroed him, basically, you know? I initiated it. He had to force his plans, you know what I mean? Whee! Oh, we're fine. Oh, I think it's in there, and I can't...
Let's look around.
I can't have it. And I think this is another locked house. I hope it's not you. What? Are we okay? We're done. The go. Okay, we want to go here. Hero of Ferelden. Oh, there it is, Dorian. There it is. Are you ready? Are you ready, Dorian? Okay, Ducky. You ready, Dorian? I don't know if I've been doing the saves when I should. Come on, game. Don't freak out on me. You know, I actually like the word Tevinter. Sounds like a cool name. Like, come here, Tevinter. Like, I don't know, like, it'd be like a cool name if you, in like the right circumstance, you know? Kind of a Roman sound to it. Well, boy, here we go.
Uh-oh, nobody's here. This doesn't bode well.
Dorian.
Oh, boy.
Father. So the whole story about the family retainer was just, what, a smokescreen?
Then you were told. I apologize for the deception, Inquisitor. I never intended for you to be involved.
Of course not. Magister Parvus couldn't come to Skyhold and be seen with the dread Inquisitor. What would people think? What is this exactly, Father? Ambush? Kidnapping? Warm family reunion?
This is how it has always been.
Yeah.
I should leave you to work this out.
Oh, no, you don't. I want a witness. I want someone to hear the truth.
Dorian, there's no need to.
I prefer the company of men. My father disapproves.
Okay.
I'll need you to explain that.
Did I stutter? Men and the company thereof, as in sex. Surely you've heard of it.
I've done it. Should we try that and see what happens? I'm interested.
I've more than heard of it, actually.
No. The Herald of Andraste. I am shocked and scandalized.
Such sarcasm.
You're not exactly subtle, O Lord Inquisitor.
I should have known that's what this
was about. No. You don't get to make those assumptions. You know nothing about the Inquisitor.
This is not what I wanted.
I'm never what you wanted, Father. Or had you forgotten?
That's a big concern in Tevinter, then.
Only if you're trying to live up to an impossible standard. Every Tevinter family is intermarrying to distill the perfect mage, perfect body, perfect mind.
Your dad's kind of ugly.
It means every perceived flaw, every aberration is deviant and shameful. It must be hidden.
Give your dad a chance.
Your father might be here to reach out. You could give him a chance.
Let's just go.
Dorian, please. If you'll only listen to me.
Why? So you can spout more convenient lies? He taught me to hate blood magic, the resort of the weak mind. Those are his words. But what was the first thing you did when your precious heir refused to play pretend for the rest of his life? You tried to change me.
I only wanted what was best for you.
You wanted the best for you? Your fucking legacy. Anything for that.
Don't leave it like this.
Don't leave it like this, Dorian. You'll never forgive yourself.
Tell me why you came.
If I knew, I would drive you to the Inquisition.
You didn't. I joined the Inquisition because it's the right thing to do. Once, I had a father who would have known that.
Come on, come on.
Once, I had a son who trusted me. A trust I betrayed. I only wanted to talk to him, to hear his voice again, to ask him to forgive me.
Go on. I will leave. This is now the time where I can leave and you will be okay to talk to your dad. I am not a subtle person. I'm an honest, not subtle person. And Talon, more so. Well, that was interesting. I didn't really peg Talon as somebody who'd already kind of done that, but I guess at the same time, it was never like he was like specifically like, I am gay. It was just like, hey, it's all good, you know? Swing both ways. That's how I kind of pictured him anyway. That's interesting. I mean, I just, like, the other options, I was like, I don't know, but this one, like, I'm intrigued. I want to see what this is about. Let's see what this goes. Doo-dee-doo. And the reactions were funny, and he's like, such sarcasm, Dorian. That was funny. I love seeing Talon's personality come out. It's fun. You all right? Oh.
He says we're alike. Too much pride. Once I would have been overjoyed to hear him say that. Now I'm not certain. I don't know if I can forgive him.
He tried to change you.
Out of desperation. I wouldn't put on a show, marry the girl, keep everything unsavory, private and locked away. Selfish, I suppose. Not to want to spend my entire life screaming on the inside. He was going to do a blood ritual. Alter my mind. Make me acceptable. I found out. I left.
Can blood magic actually do that?
Maybe. It could also have left me a drooling vegetable. It crushed me to think he found that absurd risk preferable to scandal. Part of me has always hoped he didn't really want to go through with it. If he had, I can't even imagine the person I would be now. I wouldn't like that, Dorian.
Are you all right?
No, not really. Thank you for bringing me out there. It wasn't what I expected, but it's
you
something.
Would have regretted it.
Maker knows what you must think of me now. After that whole display.
Good things. Oh no, is this gonna go places? Are my doors locked? Okay. You are brave. And you are trouble. But those are good things.
I don't think less of you. More, if possible.
The things you say.
I mean...
My father never understood. Living a lie, it festers inside of you like poison. You have to fight for what's in your heart.
I agree.
Gilding! Oh, go!
I see you enjoy playing with fire, Inquisitor. At any rate, time to drink myself into a stupor. It's been that sort
I shouldn't
of day.
Have kissed him.
Join me sometime, if you've a
he's
mind.
He's hurting right now. That was a bad time. It was a bad time to kiss him.
I don't know what you think
what?
You're doing.
Me?
I'm being clucked at by
oh,
a
whoa,
head.
Whoa.
Don't play the fool with me, young
whoa.
Man.
If I wanted to play the fool, I could be rather more convincing, I
he's
assure
he's over
you.
There.
Your glib tongue does you no credit.
You'd be surprised at the credit my tongue
yum,
gets
yum.
Me, Your Reverence.
What's going on?
Oh, I...
What's going
don't
on
listen, my boy.
It seems the revered mother is concerned about my undue influence.
You have no idea!
It is just concern. Your worship, you must know how this looks.
You might need to spell it out, my dear.
This man is of Tevinter. His presence at your side, the rumors alone.
What's wrong with him being from Tevinter, specifically?
Tell me, please.
I'm fully aware that not everyone from the Imperium is the same.
How kind of you to notice. Yet still, you bow to the opinion of the masses.
The opinion of the masses is based on
centuries of bigotry.
What would you have me tell them?
The truth?
The truth is I do not know you, and neither do they. Thus, these rumors will continue.
Tell me.
Oh? I'd like to hear what these rumors are, exactly.
I could not repeat them, your worship.
Repeat them? So you've shared them before?
I...
Uh-huh.
See, I meant no disrespect, Inquisitor. Only to ask after this man's intentions. If you feel he is without ulterior motive, then I humbly beg forgiveness of you both.
She means well, but it's not her business.
Well, that's something.
She didn't get to you, did she?
No. It takes more to get to me than thinly veiled accusations.
You don't think she'll do anything?
Do what? Yours is the good opinion I care about, not hers. It does make me wonder. Is my influence over you undue?
He asked a very similar question when I was a female and we were just friends, so it's not meant romantically. Should I, joking? Let me see.
Perhaps. But it's the kind of undue influence I enjoy.
No one accused you of being...
Nope!
Not today.
I tease you too much, I know.
Your wit is useful.
It's helpful when you turn that scathing wit on people other than me.
I'll have to find something we can do that doesn't involve teasing. Soon, I...
This is fun just for the laughs. For the laughs, Dorian. For the lols. I'm having so much fun. This is so fun.
Fancy meeting you.
I know. We should talk about what? I'm good.
I should go. Here I thought we were just getting...
Yeah, your face isn't rendering, Dorian, so I can't talk to you. Anyway, I'm gonna call this part here. Maybe next time we'll have to see what that other option does. Oh, God. Vivian, I need to talk to Vivian. Oh, let's turn in some stuff.
Here is the request Harriet made. Are there any special instructions? No, I would have stated as much.
Yes, of course. I'll be...
Okay, I walk, look at me.
Of course you will. You're
look at that.
You may depart.
He's such a man. Oh, good. Running is more normal. Walking? He walks like he's got something stuck between his legs. Like, really uncomfortably. Like, he's been riding a horse for, like, 7 days. Anyway, I'm gonna call it here. I have no idea how long the episode is. I appreciate you all for putting up with the, weirdness that happened. Hopefully it all works out, because that was hilarious. The kissing wasn't as weird as I thought it was going to be, but the kissing is weird regardless. I loved Solas with all my heart. The kissing scenes with him are incredibly awkward. I could do without them. Really. Like, they're just really awkwardly done. So, kissing's always awkward in video games. But that wasn't too terribly bad. It wasn't too mushy-gishy, so that's nice. Thank you guys if you're watching this. I hope you're liking it. Those of you who are watching it, I'm glad we're all having a good time. Okay. I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks.